Hey everybody, Brandon here from iDub Hockey, and today I'm here to help you on how to size a shin guard. Now, you want to have the correct size because you want optimal coverage between your ice hockey pant and your skate, and two, you want to have full mobility during gameplay. Now, you can wear a shin guard two different ways. The first way is over your skate tongue. The second way is underneath your skate tongue. Now, while it does come down to personal preference, it's more of a style, but they're going to have two different measurements. So let's get started. All right, in order to do this, we're gonna wanna grab a tape measure. If you don't have a tape measure, you can use a piece of string and then measure that with a ruler or another measuring device. You're gonna wanna have your skates on your feet and then sitting down so your knee is at a 90 degree angle. This is gonna give you your most accurate measurement. And then what we're gonna do, let's start off with wearing your shin guard underneath your skate tongue. So what you're gonna do is take your measurement and you wanna start underneath the tongue to where this top of the boot top of the skate boot. So it's gonna be about an inch or two underneath the skate tongue, and then measure up and then go to the center of your kneecap. In my case is 13 inches. And then if you wanna wear your shin guard on top of your skate tongue, you're gonna wanna start on the top of the tongue where that skate boot is, measure to the center of the kneecap, it's 14 inches. So typically speaking, that measurement is gonna be an inch difference whether you wear it underneath or over the skate tongue, but it's pretty easy to match. If you're 14 inches, you're gonna be a 14 inch shin guard. If you're in between measurements, I would recommend rounding to the nearest inch. Now, I do wanna mention that each brand does have different sizing guidelines, so you always wanna make sure that you are looking at their chart on the product page. All right, now it's time to put on your shin guard and check for a proper fit. I've gone ahead and put on a 14 and a 13 inch shin guard because that is what I measured for the top of the tongue and underneath. Now there's gonna be two areas you wanna look at. The first is gonna be the knee. You want your knee centered in the knee donut. This is gonna allow the shin guard to properly flex when you're taking your strides. And as well, the knee donut is designed to cradle the knee. The second area is gonna be down low, right where the skate is. So as you can see, my 14 inch shin guard meets the top of my skate boot. So you have proper coverage in between the skate and the shin guard. Wearing it underneath, you can see as well, the shin guard is very close to the top of the skate boot. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you want it as close as possible. Now, I do want to mention one more time that you want to decide whether you want to wear your shin guard over or underneath your skate tongue. Because let's say I wanted to wear my 14 inch underneath my skate tongue. So right away, the tongue is pushing out way too far. And the knee is now sitting way, or the knee donut is sitting way above my kneecap, so I'm not getting any proper protection, and it's gonna not flex with my knee. And for the 13 inch, if I wanted to go on top of the skate tongue, right away you can see the major gap in protection between my skate boot and my shin guard. All right, now it's time to see what an improper fitting shin guard looks like when it's too small. So I have it centered on my knee, so I have the good flex and mobility, but when it comes to gap protection down near my skate, there's too big of a gap. That's gonna leave you exposed to pucks hitting your ankle. And then on the outside, the calf protection doesn't properly cover my calf either. So it's gonna feel too constrictive and leave too many gaps in protection. Now let's take a look at a shin guard that's too big. You may not have gaps in protection down low, but the shin guard is gonna feel loose and wiggle around on you. But most importantly, your knee is not gonna be centered with the knee donut. So it's not gonna properly cover a very vital area of your body if you take a collision. As well, the brake is not where it needs to be, and the thigh protection is gonna be battling with your hockey pants. So once again, it's gonna feel very uncomfortable on the ice and limit your range of motion. If you guys are ready to start shopping, you can hit the link in the description where you can check out our wide selection of shin guards. If you guys want more information on how to size and even select other pieces of hockey equipment, you can head over to our website where we have a learning center just for you. Overall, thanks for watching and subscribe to our channel so you can stay updated on all the new incoming hockey gear.